Come saying on. That too. I always hope that Lexi behaves herself. I am rarely
really a vain hope.
Yeah, I'm rarely believing of that. Okay, what do we got here? We got another piece of cotton art. Apparently, she's got super blushy freckles going on. I like it. I like it. I feel like
it's
you might have
blush,
taken.
It's a bit of dirt.
Oh, it's a bit of dirt. Okay, so it's like blush, but worse. I like it though. I like it.
What?
Let me see if I can get this to the chat real quick. There we go. This is Adelaide. For y'all at home, if you don't know, then now you know, Mr. President.
Oh, that's a cute picture.
Thank you.
Where do we leave off? Pondo was about to get the shit kicked out of him. That's right. Warren, you arrive at the bar with your good new friend, whose name you don't know. You just know he's a Commodore with the Texans. He wraps his arm around your shoulder and gestures to the bartender and says, "Good sir, I was hoping I might sample your special selection in the back room, in the chilled area. I assume that it's well insulated, not a lot of noise, very cool." And the bartender is like looking at him for a moment, and then he like looks between the two of you, and then kind of a realization comes over his face. He says, "Yeah, yes, of course, just over this way. Take the third room on the left."
Can that's... I loudly say, "That's a really cool knife"?
Yes, you can. Warren, you hear, you turn when she says, "That's a really cool knife." You see a guy that's about to gut Adelaide, and he's like, "Woman, get your hands off me." And she's like, "That's a really cool knife." He's like, "This is a big knife, okay?"
I think Warren's like just listening to the description.
The two of you are struggling over the knife, and he's like, "Get your hands off of it. What are you doing running into me? Touching my knife. You know what it is to touch a man's knife?"
I don't know what it is. It's just so cool. I wanted to compliment you on it.
I'm gonna need you to make a knife fighting check here real quick, because you were in a knife battle with the dude.
What's
duties.
A knife fighting check?
It's a melee check.
A brawl?
I will absolutely allow brawl to be used here in opposition to his melee. So you are rolling one purple, one red, one black.
Can I assist?
How do you assist? You have an arm wrapped around you. There's a guy between you and her, and the dude who's holding you doesn't seem to be in a mood to let you go very quickly.
I'm just going to yell out, Barbara!
You're not going to assist with that. I will require you to make a different roll.
Okay.
To initiate a free-for-all bar brawl. I want to be clear that if you fail, you're just going to be that dumbass that says bar brawl. You're like the guy at the concert that throws themselves out like, "Yeah!" And you do not get picked up by the audience.
Currently, as Warren was like just listening to that description of the freezer, essentially.
Yeah, they're taking you into the freezer.
Yeah, and then seeing someone had a knife behind them. So, yeah, it's either... start a brawl to be a distraction, or, you know, just get beat up soon.
Two purple, charm check. Or leadership, if you prefer.
They're both the same.
Okay. Good luck. I'm actually going to spend my GM power to bump that purple up to a red.
Okay, so one purple, one red?
Yes.
Okay. Success and a triumph.
Look, man, you don't just start a bar brawl. You start the bar brawl. This is exactly what the Commodore didn't want. One of the Texans punches one of the Mexicans. The Mexican begins shouting in Spanish. And then knives are coming out on all sides. Someone gets punched with a beer stein, and now he's got like half of a beer stein, and the other half is like ceramic and glass shards. Shit is breaking down, and the Commodore is like, "You've just made my life incredibly difficult."
Well, you're about to stab me for a moment, so that's kind of fine by me.
So he continues pulling you deeper into the facility. He's fully intent on this man behind you and him dragging you into the freezer. And he's like, I have some very pointed questions to ask you. And by pointed, I mean, and then he lets up his wrist and then like spring loaded knife comes out and into his hand that he grabs as it goes past. You hear like a little, like a alarm bell from a clock, like ding. I was like, that's right. Steam powered.
I don't have like a gun or anything that I,
do you have a gun on your character sheet?
I believe you
don't have a gun or anything.
I don't know if we had a starting budget or anything.
You did. You had 500. You could have a gun.
Oh yeah, then yes, I do have a gun.
Fantastic. I actually want to cut over to Adelaide. Adelaide, you are going to get 2 boost die because this guy is now distracted by the Mexicans around him. Let's go ahead and make that roll.
What's the boost die?
2 blue.
Okay.
That's true. It does look less chibi and more Disney princess.
It's as a note that I've got the knack for it in brawling. So I noticed the 2 black things, the squares.
Yes. I don't think there are any black dice on this.
I don't know how it works. I just took it.
Yep. It just means that incidentals don't bother you. So 1 purple, 1 red, no black, 2 blue dice. You fail real bad. You fail horribly. And you got some advantage. Okay, so look, I have really bad news for you.
Okay.
You get stabbed. That's
fair.
You take 4 points of damage.
That's a wound, right?
It is, but you absorb 1 point for soak. The stab cuts some of the leather on your like mechanic's smock, and you feel a little sting of a cut exposed to open air, and it gets even worse when someone splashes some whiskey on the wound, and you're like, ah! However, I will allow you to spend your 2 advantage in 1 of 2 ways. You can either have this guy stab one of his allies, like he stabs you and goes past, and you force him to stab one of his allies, or you can push him into a Mexican.
I want to push him into a Mexican.
All right, you push him into a Mexican. He's like, ah! The Mexican turns around, steam knife out as well. The 2 of them begin circling each other. And the Mexican uses his other hand to like pull down a thing. That he's got like steampunk goggles as well, but then you hear like a charging noise, like he starts saying something in Spanish. All the Spanish people start looking away and closing their eyes. What do you do?
I kind of want to look around and see what happened to Warren.
Okay, you look around and see what happened to Warren. As you're looking around, suddenly you're blinded and you hear a You're like, ah! Something very bright flashes you in the face. Warren, in the corridor you're in, there's a sudden flash, like a daguerreotype going off. That's camera flash. And you're being dragged around the corner. You can hear Adelaide, like, stabbing somebody or something. There's definitely a woman's voice being involved in, like, a stab-off.
Well, that's not great. Does it, I don't know if I'd be able to see. Does it look like that they...
No, you're around the corner. Oh, you're doing something with the Commodore?
Yeah, so the flash, I could see the flash.
Yeah, like, yeah. Like, me? If someone was taking a picture in another room, you would see the flash.
Oh, okay.
Yep.
I don't know what I could do.
Try to struggle and break free like a Magikarp on the verge of becoming a glorious Gyarados. Sam, just like Pokemon again. Really?
Yeah, let's just let that hang there, everybody.
Yeah, I heard about your infatuation with Misty.
Actually, probably. Yeah, I was like, quick, everybody, brawl in the freezer.
All right, that's your go-to, Adelaide. You hear York talking about brawl in the freezer. By the time your eyes clear. Most of the Texas contingent is being pummeled the shit out of by their Mexican counterparts. The Mexicans have definitely been overrunning them. They were all prepared for this flash. You're being left alone. They don't know who you are. You're not wearing colors. You were fighting the Texans. temporarily you're without a dance partner in this fight. What do you want to do?
Hey, the Texans are sneaking up to the freezer.
That's a good one. That's really good. Three of the Mexican contingent begin drawing like short swords, and one of them draws like an aetheric rifle from over his shoulder, and you hear it begin charging, and they begin storming that way. One of them tosses you a coin and is like, "Hey, thanks. Let's go mess him up, boys. That's the Commodore."
Yeah, thanks for getting revenge on the guy who stabbed me.
No problem. All right, we're in. They open the door to the freezer area when all of a sudden two guys with machetes and a dude with a gigantic aetheric rifle come around the corner and like, "Get them! They're the Texans!" They do not seem to make. They are not making a distinction between you and them. They believe that you are also Texan.
No, senora, and you're not Texan.
God, I will allow you to sell me on this because you told me you're a face character. But this deception check, your life depends on its success, yeah. Sir.
Pretty much.
Fucking your deception better be really, really good. I'm just going to go ahead and throw two black dice on here because you don't look Mexican and you don't sound Mexican. You're rolling. I'm going to throw a GM thing in here too. I'm throwing my other story point on this as well. It's one purple, one red, two black dice on your deception.
I would burn a story point right back.
Okay, yeah. Mark your story point and then give yourself...
I'm saying that as a suggestion.
Oh, okay. All right.
What does it do if I burn a story point?
You can upgrade a green die to a yellow, and if you're out of green to yellows, then you can just give yourself another green.
Didn't you already burn your story point?
So yeah, your story points are in a pool. You guys can always tap them. And you guys now have all...
Versus dark side points, they go back and forth.
Yeah, exactly. Right? You guys have all of the story points now. I just spent my last one.
Hey, we should definitely spend one so he doesn't die in a freezer.
Yeah, that's... Yeah, I'll spend one.
All right, so you can just click one point into upgrade on your sheet. And it'll upgrade one of your die. Go ahead and make your roll, motherfucker.
I didn't do it, so I'm just gonna do it manually. So, okay. All right. Well, here it goes. Well.
You have one advantage and no successes.
That could have been worse.
I don't know how much worse you can get than being shot by the Mexican mafia, but okay.
Well, I could have had threats.
Yeah, you could have literally, practically been worse. You should have gone with "I'm Canadian."
I mean, it's true.
I love the idea that Canada is somehow independent in this universe.
No matter what universe it's
just
in.
Je sois, sir! I am not with these Texas dogs! I am Le Franc!
So I get shot. Could I get less shot with the advantage? Or just shot
I you? Will let you spend the advantage to not get shot. Instead, you will get stabbed.
That sounds much better.
The one who's shooting... hesitates shooting you and goes to shoot the dude who's trailing, and the other two guys run forward to engage everybody in melee combat, and one of them comes at you with a cutlass. What's your plan?
Dodge.
Okay, all right, make a brawl check.
That's not great. Okay,
versus one purple, one red.
Damn it.
Wow. Okay. You managed to walk away with one advantage and no successes. So you get stabbed. It's 4 points of damage.
I soak one.
It's not good getting stabbed. It's real bad. You kind of wriggle out of the way, you dodge, you strain yourself in the process. The flat of the blade slides along the side of you and cuts a thin gash.
Sorry. Oh, thank you for saving me.
I will let you spend the advantage to be disengaged with everybody here.
Yeah, I'm gonna leave.
So you don't leave. They're between you and the exit, but you're no longer being held by the Texan Commodore. None of the other Texans are about to stab you. You just, in the process, you take a free step back and nobody bothers you.
Can I try to leave?
Yes. Yes, you can. You want to rush past two guys with cutlass machetes. Two Texans with unknown armament.
Settle the doubts.
Okay. Just to remind you, the Mexicans still believe you're Texan, so settling it out requires killing you.
Look, I'm sorry. I'm not really with them at all. I'm actually from somewhere completely else.
Adelaide, I want to cut to you to maybe help out this situation. Were you following these Mexicans as they rounded the corner?
Casually.
Okay. Casually stroll around the corner and you get a blast of steam in your face as the aetheric rifle fires. You're like, but you're used to it because you're a mechanic. You get sprayed in the face by aetheric current all the time. One Texan is down. He just, there's like a fist-sized hole in him where he got shot by the rifle. The Commodore has sword and pistol and is fighting the other two Mexican gang members in like melee combat, and he's constantly like firing the revolver, but they're both so close, can't hit. You see Warren like backing away. He seems to be I'm not with them. It's really pathetic. What do you want to do? You're directly behind the dude with the aetheric rifle who has not noticed you.
Well, can I just say, hey, Warren, there's a fight this way. We can kick some Texan butt.
You want to convince these guys that...
No. I want to convince them that Warren can go kick Texan butt with me.
Yes, exactly.
Oh, yes. Yes, I can totally do that.
You want to convince these guys that... Warren isn't Texan, and that you all will help kick the Texan's ass. Texas.
Yes.
Very well. This check has already been failed, so it's going to increase in difficulty. You will need to make a charm check at 2 red.
Guys, aid?
I don't think that's wise.
That's fair. All right.
Do I get any bonuses for already having
a... You know what? I'll give you one boost die.
It was 2 like red, right?
Yes, 2 red, 1 boost die. Let's see how good it is.
I'm
going to
burn a story point.
Okay,
yeah, you're using I'll do that because I'm really bad at this.
Okay, click use story point and give yourself a upgrade die. So click 1 on upgrade.
Okay.
And then make your roll. Show me the power of your dice. You have a success, an advantage, and a despair. Oh my goodness.
Oh my God.
That despair is going to be super bad for you right now. So the good news is that they are probably going to believe that you and Warren are here to go kick the Texans' ass. The only question is, how do I make that despair make your life so much worse? Interpreting the dice pool. Despair. Do-do-do-do-do. So you didn't fail. You're just in a bit of problem. Oh my goodness. Look, let me jump back over to Cornelius and Hero, and we'll see the outcome of your role in just a minute. The two of you, where are you taking this engineer, and what are you doing with him?
Who is this guy again?
This is a man. His name is Tiberius K. James. He's a second in command of the special project that you've heard about will probably be being used in order to cause some problems. It's supposed to be a super weapon that will destroy the British Empire.
What do you think, Sid? Like, should we just go like steal the guy's clothes and like let's embarrass him, or like should we go like interrogation mode? Should we go like buddy buddy? How do you want to do this?
Start with buddy buddy, get all the information we can, and then go interrogation mode.
Well, he's your buddy right now.
Yeah, we're already like super buddy buddy. Yeah, so like we've kind of we're shooting for information, right? That's kind of what we're dealing with.
That was the objective, is trying to learn as much as possible right now.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I think we just go hard. Like, I think we just like triple down on the violence with this guy.
You're gonna just beat the shit out of him.
Right. I mean, is that what we're thinking, Cornelius? Think it'll work? I mean,
if Buddy Buddy is working, then we may as well stick with Buddy Buddy because it's frankly easier.
True. Yeah, but where are we taking him? We told him we would take him to our special project, and yeah. Okay. Sure. So we cut, and we're in my captain's quarters, whatever captain's quarters are in this ship.
Oh, Aethe, look fantastic. Everything is gold leaf finished. Sure. Brass plumbing. There's a bar that you've clearly liberally used.
Uh-huh.
Plenty of snacks and fruits.
Yeah. So we have like Cornelius is standing behind Tiberius. Oh God, your names are so similar. And we see like my like desk, like the ledger on it, the pipes coming through the desk and stuff like that. And there's like a mug on the desk. And I'm like by the desk, I'm looking at the mug and I'm pointing at it. And I'm like, I look up at Tiberius and I'm like, my special project, you see it? There it is. And I'm like pointing at the mug.
So yeah, he pulls out a pair of steam-powered bifocals and puts them on, and then like the second pair comes out, and then a third that like they get increasingly smaller to zoom in, and he's like, is it some form of bacterium then? What's in this mug? A weapon of some kind? Is it a potency of strength enhancement? Or have you figured out a way in order to turn people into one of those horrible rat folk that I've heard about that pervade the British Empire?
Yeah, so like he just sees my face, like my big old eyes on the other side, and blink, blink, like do the blink thing.
There am I, very large.
Boop. And I go, no, the special project, it is the mug.
My goodness, the mug.
It's just like a nice mug.
What's so special about it?
It's just a nice mug that Hero bought like at a China shop.
Yeah, no, he's insistent that you you well, tell him saying? What is special about this mug.
That's it. It's sorry, shit. That's it. It's just a nice mug. Isn't that a nice mug?
I get it. You were having a laugh with me.
Okay. I grab his hair and smash his head into the mug.
Okay.
All right. Joker style.
Yeah. Just like, the like, mug shit, the mug shatters. I don't know what to do. What do you want out of him?
As soon as he gives me that, like...
There's cuts on his face. He's crying. He's upset. He doesn't know what's happening, and he's trying to struggle with his whole body. Yeah.
I'm like, now that he's like kind of more or less incapacitated on the floor, I'm like pacing back and forth in front of Cornelius.
Oh, he's
like,
not incapacitated at all. If you let your hands off of him, he's gonna go for his gun.
Oh, then I'll kick whatever gun he's got out of his holster.
Okay, all right, I need you to make a brawl check.
I think while he's doing that and holding him down, I just walk up behind and then pull the gun out of the holster.
All right, yeah. I'll let you make a brawl check with two blue dice. You're rolling against one red, one purple, one black.
Hold on, I might have a thing, but I need to look it up, and it's confusing because these sheets have a ton of shit on it. Because I'm a guy that can do a thing.
You are a guy. There are occasionally things you can do.
And I don't remember what it gives me, and I should have looked this up beforehand. Oh no, it hurts.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know what page my thing is on, Arthur? Do you have any idea? Oh, 152. I think changing will help me, right? Am I crazy?
If you want to use your mongrel power to turn into like a rat man, yes.
You might want a day though, right?
That is correct. It will increase your brawn and agility, so it'll help you out. And when you make unarmed attack, which you're about to do, you get plus one damage.
Yeah, fuck it.
Okay, all right. Make a discipline check. It's three purple.
What's the drawback of this? What happens if I fail?
Nothing will happen. You'll have just exceeded your check.
Where the fuck are my? Is that on my character sheet?
It is skills, on there your it character is. Sheet. Skills.
There's so discipline. Many like tabs. Discipline versus
three purple. Versus one.
Fuck.
Yeah, you're not very good at this.
Is it a discipline check or a brawl check?
He's making a discipline check to turn into a were-rat.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
That, whatever that is.
Holy shit. You unleash the beast within. You tap deep into your blood, into that toxic, alchemically altered blood, and you pull out your rat form with your disgusting tail and your weirdly furry face. You look like Detective Pikachu. as you get a burst of strength, you have an extra brawn die, which will give you one more green die to your brawl right now.
Wait, why do I have one blue? Oh, that was
you. Actually, you have two blue right now because Cornelius is going for the gun.
Yeah. So I have two blue, one green, and against three purple.
No, now you're going against one red, one purple.
One, and then I click brawn.
Yes.
No, wait, yes. I can't roll brawn.
Brawl.
Oh, brawl.
Brawl.
It's skills.
That's
a success. All right. The two of you working together take the gun out of his holster, get a hold of him, and start smashing him until he stops moving.
Yeah, I like pick him up. I'm like, I like smash him against the wall.
My god, you are one of those disgusting rat folk.
Smash him again, and I pull out his gun and hand it to Courtney. It's like, here you go. And I smash him a third time.
You know, I drop him to the ground. Smith & Wesson models with the extended barrel. You know, they only made about 5,000 of these.
Yeah, I dropped the guy to the ground, turned to Cornelius. I'm like,
47, you know, is
only 5,000.
Yes.
Really?
Why do you guys sound super British right now?
Because they're actually quite garbage, you see.
Shut up, fool. And I kick him in the head.
Oh, no. Stop. I thought you were from Detroit.
I thought that's how they did it in Detroit.
I apologize, Detroit. Fuck SIdAlpha.
Yikes. Yeah, because where else in the United States can you get a house for $250?
Yeah,
where
exactly.
Where else? There's something to be said for that. So I don't know where we go from here.
All right. I'll give you two a minute to think about it. Maybe chat on Discord, pop it back and forth. Warren, York, Adelaide, Burke. The Mexicans believe you for that one crucial moment. Their fight continues, but they allow Warren to go past. You and Adelaide turn to leave to go fight the rest of the Texans. When Warren's pants catch on something, it tears a little bit, and his underwear, which has the British flag on them, shows. His pants fall down. The guy with the aetheric rifle that's standing right next to you turns and says, "He's one of them British spies." No, sorry, that's not Mexican at all. "Amigos, he's one of them British spies. They're both in on it." And he turns. He has to like take a step back and lean back in order to point the rifle. Can't seem to pick between the two of you, but you have a brief moment before one of you is definitely going to get shot. What would the two of you like to do? You are past these guys. You could disappear around a corner pretty quickly, but someone shouted ahead of you that you're British spies. Warren, you have no pants, and you're wearing your British flag underwear.
I'm very upset with you. I just want you to know that.
That is what a critical failure on a social check looks like, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, I forgot I had these, apparently. The Commodore was the one that squealed.
The two of you...
He's like motioning for Adelia to run.
All right, the two of you stop, do some quippy remarks. Adelaide, do you run?
Yeah, I go around the corner and hope that he follows.
Warren, the gun settles on you then. What do you want to do? You have a guy that's within arm's reach pointing an etheric rifle at you. You see the canister begin to fill with etheric energy. In about two heartbeats, he's going to pull that trigger and you will probably vaporize.
Let me see my skills.
No, stop, I swear, I'm not with the British. I'm not with the Texans, nor am I with the British. I'm Canadian. Can't you tell?
He went to spell spies. He's spying on the British
force. Go deeper.
That would be a really deep lie. No, I'm a triple agent. Well, I really am with agent. Mexico.
I really see no other point. I guess I try to shoot him back.
All right.
In hopes that it buys me enough time to escape.
You go for your gun, and you realize that it was in your pants. You reach down to your pants, which are between your legs. Pull your gun up. You're coming up at this guy with the gun pointed up at him while he's pointing a rifle down at you. So yeah. Let's go ahead and make opposed gunnery checks to see who fires first and who dies.
I'll burn a story point.
Yeah, that sounds like a real good plan, buddy. That sounds like a real good plan. Oh, Pondo, you've gotten yourself in pretty deep.
It's all because I failed one roll.
That is unfortunately how life works.
Yeah.
All right. So he has some defense from his armor. So we're going to throw a black die on this. So it's one black die, two purple, and one red.
Okay, it's not going to be great. I'm dead.
You got a despair on your roll. So you succeeded, but you rolled a despair on a combat check. Which will be bad, but it won't be as bad as being shot. Well, actually, it'll probably be worse than being shot, but at least you won't be dead.
My gun blows up and I die immediately.
Your gun blowing up is the thing that could happen, yes. Man, that was a really satisfying donking noise, actually.
Yeah, sorry.
I super liked it.
You want me to do it again, baby?
No, I'm good.
All right. You just DM me later. I'll donk you anytime you want.
I like this one. All right. You shoot first, Han Solo. You shoot him in the shoulder. He goes down, but in the process, he pulls the trigger of the aetheric rifle. It's gone off kilter. He's aiming down. Now he's falling. The barrel's going up. It brushes against your steam pistol. And as the aetheric rifle fires, it generates a convection field around it, and your revolver barrel melts.
I am perfectly fine with that.
So you are free and clear for the moment. Adelaide, no one has reacted to the fact that there was a shot that there's a British spy in here yet. The Mexicans are now gathering up all of the Texans in the center of the room and tying them up. They see you run around the corner, and they just kind of don't really know what's going on. What do you do? That's when they hear the aetheric rifle go off a second time, and one of them starts heading towards you to check in on what's happening.
They got the Commodore back there.
Yeah. He starts going to walk past you. Warren, there's a Mexican guy walking towards you now. He notices you on the ground. He hasn't noticed that you're wearing British flag underwear because you got dropped on your ass, but your legs are tangled up in your pants. There's a dead Mexican near you, and there's an aetheric rifle laying nearby. How do you get out of this situation without being killed? Adelaide, this guy's walking past you, and he's starting to move towards Warren, and he's like, "What's happening over there, amigo? You guys take too many drinks while taking down the Commodore?"
Commodore's back in the freezer. There was, like, two of them back there fighting them.
All right, so he turns back towards you, Adelaide, and nods and says, "Thanks. Okay, let's go mess him up."
I pull up my pants.
Yep. You pull up your pants.
And
this guy is still walking towards you. It's real soon he's gonna notice that that's a dead Mexican at your feet.
Am I able to get the hat of like any sort of like garb or anything?
You want to steal Mexican? Somebody's hat?
Either the hat or maybe a jacket.
Yeah, you grab a sombrero.
And I quickly leave.
All right. So you are holding your pants up, holding a sombrero on your head, leaving your steam revolver behind, trying to rush out as quickly as possible with Adelaide before this guy notices that's a dead Mexican that you just left on the floor and you're running away from. Got it. I need you to make a athletics check here real quick.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. I'm sure you're good at these. You seem like the kind of person who would be.
Yeah.
Two purple, and I'm going to go ahead and use one of them GM story points in order to make it a purple and a red.
Can I assist?
Yep. How do you assist in his pulling his pants up, holding a sombrero, and not getting shot?
I want to try and get more of the Mexicans to like head into the freezer by saying the first one to get to the Commodore wins and see if they can go in there faster.
Okay. All right. Go ahead, Warren.
You know, create a wave of distraction.
Yeah.
Do I add anything?
You add one blue die.
Okay, well.
Good luck.
Right. Shit. Nope,
no successes. All right, several more people come by. The first dude who went down the corridor is like, hey, get up, get up. And then like three more Mexicans come by and they're like, that dude is dead, amigo. All four of them turn towards Warren and Adelaide, who are just about to turn the corner out of this establishment, the Totem Cat. And they all pull out their pistols and aim them awkwardly at you. And they're like, stop right there. We're going to shoot you, amigos. Is that what you do? You go, a bunch of times?
Is there anything... I don't know, like a fire alarm system or anything?
No, there are no fire alarms in the 19th century. Sam's like, that's it. I'm doing some fire alarm research right here.
That's fair. So the Commodore is dead, right?
You have no idea. The Commodore was fighting the last time you saw. But now there are... a half dozen Mexicans between him and not death. So, Adelaide, you got any ideas?
Commodore right over there. He's a very skilled man with a very dangerous weapon.
You are not going to be able to trick them into not shooting you now that they know you killed a guy.
It wasn't me that killed the guy. It was the Commodore.
Okay. You know what? I will allow for this. It's going to be extremely difficult. And once I tell you how hard it is, you won't be able to back out. Are you sure you want to do this?
I mean, I've got nothing else in the situation.
Okay. All right. It's two red, one purple, one black.
Okay. Okay.
You're attempting to lie to somebody about a crime you not only definitely committed, but were almost seen doing. In the background, the Commodore is like, he's with me! He's with the Texans! Houston forever!
Story point.
All right. Now, we've mostly been using story points proactively, but I'm not going to use any of my story points, so you can actually downgrade one of my red to the purple if you would like. Or you can boost one of yours from a green to a yellow.
Bump one of yours down.
Okay. That's an interesting and possibly wise move. We'll see.
Yeah, let's go for it.
Yeah, let's go for it. Jesus Christ. Did you really get four successes?
Yep.
All right. You and Adelaide both take 1 point of strain as you have to dash around the corner, dodge roll, as all four guns go off and there's like a dozen bullets going through the area, and then you hear them ricocheting off of stuff. Beer, bing, 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 bing. Pachow! Pew, pew. You don't get shot though. Congratulations. We cut back to Cornelius and Babara. What's your plan? You've got this guy. He's pretty injured. He's still resisting you.
Oh, he's still resisting us?
Well, yeah. I mean, he's part of the Free Texas Militia. Have you ever known a Texan to surrender at any point in their entire life?
No, I really haven't.
So he's just like, when I get out of this chair, I'm going to turn you into a something that doesn't look so good. His face is covered in mug injuries, scalding hot coffee. Well, you probably were drinking scalding hot tea. Ceramic cuts. There's a mug-shaped scar on his face now, you know, from the impact wound.
I guess we just go through the old GTA 5 torture scene.
Okay. I don't think we need to be that graphic. Who's leading this torture scene? You or Cornelius?
Let's take him down to the boiler room and put his head against one of the hot pipes for a while.
Sure. Okay. We're going to get real serious. Maybe take it back a little bit, but all right.
So we cut back to us and we're in the boiler room.
Yep.
I'm still in mongrel form, like hairy. I'm like stripping off my shirt and like letting it hang down. And I'm like shirtless there. And I'm still like a 5'3" tiny little hairy boy now. I have him by one hand. And as we get to the door of the boiler, I look back to Cornelius. I just go like, hello, Doc. I'm not really sure if this is kind of your deal or not. You can come in if you want. I don't know. Are you interested?
Son, there's something you have to remember. I've seen far more in my day than you could possibly imagine. This is nothing new. But I remember the time back in 1824. It was...
Right.
Has the torture begun? Is this it?
Yeah, so we montage. Can we roll with an assist? And
yeah, so you're rolling coercion then, hero. You get one blue die from Cornelius and two from the situation, and you're rolling against two purple. However, I'm gonna book one of those purple to a red.
So one purple, one red.
Yes.
I'm gonna use a destiny point. I'm gonna use a thing to do something. Whatever they do.
You can bump one of your greens to a yellow.
Do I have a green?
If you don't, then you generate an extra green.
What are we talking about? Coercion? I have two yellows.
All right, so now you have two yellows and a green.
So I put a blue and a green against a purple and
three
red.
Blues.
And
then
three blues. You have three.
One
green.
From Cornelius, two from having beat the shit out of this guy so far.
So three blues, a green against a purple and a red. And then I have two yellows in coercion. So this is going to be easy peasy.
Okay.
Right.
It was pretty easy.
That's
all right. You can ask this guy three questions that he will answer without fail. You need to, however, both take one strain from the force of the interrogation. We see him again. His jaw looks a little loose. He's missing a tooth. Blood is coming down his face, but he's got like a scald wound on the other side of his face where the hot tea didn't hit him.
Yeah.
All right. I'll tell you what you want to know.
I look at Cornelius.
Yeah, hey, Cornelius.
Yeah. I stand up a little straighter and I start bombarding him with questions.
You have three questions, so choose wisely.
Oh. Let's see.
I got a smile out of Pondo from that one.
How do we get to the secret weapon, maybe?
Right.
Or...
He says, okay.
Okay. I'm spitballing with Sid really quick. How do we get to the secret weapon, maybe? Or like, who's in charge of the whole place? Or... something like that. I think how we get to the secret weapon is probably like pretty high on our mandatory list, right?
Okay, so our overall objective is to find the secret weapon and like take it out.
I think that's the avenue that we're going at until Pondo comes and fucks everything that we've done up so far.
and he's already basically told us what the secret weapon is, yes?
Kind of. He's alluded to kind of what it does, will do. It's a weapon that will help them win the war against the British at Jamestown. So we know it's a weapon of sorts.
To pay attention very closely to me, all right? This secret weapon, I want you to tell me precisely what it is.
Okay. All right, look. It's an aetheric convergence ray. It uses two synchronized... aetheric reactors in order to create a sort of convergence flux between it. We've managed to stabilize the flux into a right-angled forward carrier wave.
So I'll be the idiot as if it's like a TV show, and I'll hit the guy and be like, in English, damn it! You know? Like, give it to me straight, Doc!
It's a death ray!
Do I know if he's... Can I tell if what he's saying even makes mechanical sense?
I mean, look, people have been trying to pair up etheric reactors, but given the unique signature of each one, it's been assumed that it couldn't... Yeah, there it is. It's been assumed that it couldn't be done. However, there are several formula at the highly theoretical end of physics that show if you could get two reactors pushing energy towards each other, there would be a right-hand field wave that would push their combined multiplicative force in a single direction.
All right. So the next two questions would probably be like, how do we get to it and how do we turn it off? Or how do we destroy it? Right? Like something like that. Sid, do you concur? Or do you have something else in mind?
Well, Cornelius is a pretty smart dude. He could probably puzzle out how to... It's very easy to destroy a thing.
Yeah, that's the question we have a little bit of leeway on. I think we need, how do we get to it, though?
Yeah, I think that would be the next.
So then I think I stomp on the guy's knee.
That's good. That's very good. Don't worry, it'll all be over soon. He'll be finished as long as you keep answering honestly.
You're going to finish me?
That's not what I said. Don't put words in my mouth, son. Why? That people always talk
about that. I grab the guy by the collar, shove him against the wall again. I scream in his face, how do we get to it?
It's the 79th floor. You need special access.
Does he have this access?
Yeah, he does.
Okay.
Like, is that your final question for him? What is the access?
Yeah. I think that's like a tied in question. I think that's a free action. I think that's a free question that comes with question two.
He reaches into his suit coat pocket and pulls out a kind of gold bar that has the emblem of the three major gangs stamped into the top of it.
I'll take it.
I mean, you could sell this thing for a pretty good amount of money, so you can see why they'd use it as an access. Only an idiot would give it away. Mm-hmm.
So do we still technically have a third question?
Yes.
Nice. What's your mother's maiden name? No, what do we got?
Let's see. We know what it is. We know where it is. We know how to get to it. What like, sorts of defenses will we be facing?
Yeah, good question. I just like parrot it. What sort of defenses?
He's just like, my mother's maiden name is Martha. It's Martha. The defenses.
Wait, her last name is Martha? That makes no sense. That's a first name.
It's a middle name. He says, my last name is Kirk. That's a first name. So,
I don't care.
Sorry, his name is Tiberius K. James. He's like,
I slap him. I slap him. I go, defenses, you idiot.
There's at least a dozen people working on the project. We've all got weapons and... Of course, it's a warship, so the crew might be boarding any minute now.
Is that enough for you, Doc?
Sounds like we'd probably better hurry then. Now, about this one. I stare at the dude.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, stop me if I go too far, Arthur, but I'm just going to like mongrel my hand into his chest.
Yep.
And just like pull out his heart.
Nope, you're good. He dies.
Yeah. I'm going to like take a sniff of the heart and lick it a little bit and then throw it in the burner.
It's fucking disgusting. I mean, just because you're a mongrel doesn't make it any less disgusting.
I grew up on the streets.
You realize that's going to make it smell in here.
It immediately begins to sizzle and smell.
I walk out and then it's like, I didn't think that through.
There is blood spraying everywhere inside the Duke's cabin. I mean, there is some high pressure liquid being released from this body now that there's no heart to contain it.
Back out of the room and close
the door. I mean, both of you are covered in blood right now. It is not hidden at all.
Right, so we quickly change. You see, it's the next time we like flash cut, we're like walking off the ship in different clothes.
All right.
And I'm like, I'm sorry about that.
From the docks, you guys are in fresh clothing. You've wiped your faces down. You see York and Burke go running past the docks, heading down to the 34th level. And there's four Mexican guys chasing them. They're like, spy! It is a British spy! Get him!
Oh, God.
I just look around. Spy! Get him! And I start chasing him.
Okay, all right.
Let's chase him! Yeah, yeah.
Wow. All right. York, that's Burke.
So smart. That's so,
so
smart.
Far, you've been running past people with pretty much abandon. You've gone down 15 levels. You miss the exit to get back on your airship or whatever the hell your plan was. And now Rathburn and Wallace have joined the team that's following you. What's the plan? What's the plan, all four players? You want to take a moment out of character to discuss this?
Do more people join in on like catch the spy kind of thing? Or like, how is this?
There is a group of people who are like going for their guns, washing some sobriety into them. Like, they've been running for over 10 levels. There are people trailing in to help chase the spy, but the main first pack that you've now joined is only four guys plus the two of you.
So.
If they manage to catch York and Burke and hold them there for a minute, you know, like 20, 30, 40 more people are going to show up for a nice spy burning.
Oh, God. I don't think we can help at all, Sid.
Much worse than help. You've hurt their cause pretty badly. I mean, you've ballooned their numbers and called for more people to join in.
Yeah, I mean, I was going to say, like, the only way I can think about it is actually helping is like picking off the guys one by one from behind.
That's kind of what my plan was to you know,
but if
come up with an excuse to chase along behind these guys and slowly.
I can't imagine we can like kill more. I can't imagine we can kill them like secretly and stealthily without being noticed faster than they're joining in on the chase, you know? Like, I don't think that's a thing.
Question, if the people joining in on the chase, is it a mixture of like.
It's probably everyone.
The Mexicans, Texans,
Independents, First Nations.
You're bringing the whole spire together, man. That's beautiful.
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
Wait, they are. They're bringing the whole spire together. I'm gonna peel off and head for the super weapon.
Yeah, I think Cornelius like nudges me and is like, hey. This way. Oh yeah, elevator. Yeah, all
right. Probably basically unguarded right now. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, as you guys begin making your way up the spire, people go trailing past you, screaming that there's a spy. Check everybody's identification, check their colors, make sure they belong to a flag. Burke, York, you've been abandoned by the rest of your team. There was no communication. You don't know what's happening. Did they double betray you? Are they working with the Mexicans now? There are four Mexicans following you. And every few seconds, they're reloading their pistols and firing another wave. What do you want to do?
I was led to believe there was like a gang. If there's just four, then I won't do that.
I mean, there are way more than four people that will catch up eventually. Right?
Eventually, but there's a chance that we
can probably... It's a marathon. These four at the front of the marathon pack, yeah, more are coming.
Surprise pick off the back two, and then we can sandwich the other two, take them out, and then get the... You know,
is that, yeah, Arthur, is that possible? Like, is that in the realm of possibility of, like, a decent answer? Okay, so let's just do that then.
You want... What weapons are you using to ambush the back two and the front two? What's your... planned takedown.
I think it's just gonna. I think the easiest way to do it is to just like I can just catch up to them in like as mongrel form, right? And just like tear one down.
It would be.
Did you already use that?
Yeah. I can use.
I have no idea.
You. So you have you unmongrel formed yourself? Once you unmongrel form, you're out of it. It should be noted that appearing as a mongrel basically gives you away as being British.
Oh well, then yeah. Yeah, I would have unmongled myself.
All right. Then you have no ability to re-become a were-rat until you are on the verge of death.
Okay.
Cornelius, hero, it's your moment to shine. With what weapons shall you ambush these fools?
Should we just shoot them? Yeah. They like walk by like, hey, and we like, pistol, let's just shoot.
Weapons, let's see, weapons. Well, I have my sword cane.
Yeah, that'll work.
Close. You're going to chase them down with your cane and at the last minute draw it and stab a guy in the back?
Oh, for some reason it didn't save my gun. I had a gun there too, but it's not in the list.
That's fine. Is this the plan then? You're going to run into close range with them and then start stabbing and shooting?
I mean, I'm just going to shoot.
Okay.
I'm going to like take the nearest cover I can.
But Cornelius is going to essentially clothesline someone with a sword.
Yeah.
Hero just shoots the other guy.
I'll shoot and take cover.
All right. Hero, I'm going to need a 2 purple roll from you with your ranged light. You'll get 2 blue dice because you're ambushing. Cornelius, same deal. Okay. With whatever weapon you're attacking with.
Ranged light. Boom.
That's, you fail.
That's a failure?
It is a failure.
Yeah, you didn't get any success.
Damn. Well, that sounds bad.
That's it's pretty bad to open up an ambush and miss.
Yeah, with 2 blues, 2 yellows. Damn.
Cornelius, you're going to need 4 successes to take out the entire group.
What? I have to get 4 successes?
Yep.
Can I aid Cornelius?
How do you aid?
I want to throw a barrel behind me so once they trip. That's what I'm gonna knock a barrel over.
Okay.
Essentially, I was going to do the same, just knocking stuff over, like making them trip.
All right. Yeah, you're just trashing all the shopkeeper's stuff, where people live. You knock over somebody's like garbage canister and strew garbage. Somebody's got a piss pot out there. You put it down, and one of the guys slips on it, like, oh God, there's piss everywhere. Cornelius. You now have 4 blue dice to add to your roll, but you're still rolling against 2 purples, and you need 4 successes in order to ambush all the guards. If you fail, they will be alerted to the fact that there are more than 2 British spies.
Maybe we should use the story point, unless you feel confident.
Story point.
Okay.
Whoever wants to spend it can spend it.
Then I'll use the story point.
Very well.
All right,
now I have the majority of story points, you fools.
Can I use my ability to take one of your story points now?
What the fuck?
Yeah, it's in the notes. I gotta read it.
Wait, yeah.
AP Gaming.
Ready for anything. Steel. Once per session, as an out of turn internet, you may move 1 story point from the game master's pool to the player's pool.
Yeah, sure.
Sure.
Take your fucking story point back. It's not like I care anyway, baka!
Jeez. Okay, so you said I'm rolling against 2 purple.
Story point, Chan, come back.
All right.
Yeah.
Here we go. Oh!
That's 5 successes and an advantage. No one sees. Hero briefly tries to make some shots, but ends up spraying bullets everywhere. These guys are caught up in Burke and York's traps. You are among them with a sword cane. And it's like fucking... You just close your eyes, let the darkness surround you, you whip the sword out, the screen goes black, and there's 4 sword slash marks. And when it comes back, you're sheathing the sword cane. Blood is spraying from all 4 of these guys as they're rolling around on the ground.
You're like a secret MI6 agent.
More people like, are
puts the cane back down on the ground and just start limp walks.
More people are coming from behind you and they're like, look over there, past that old man. They just killed some Mexicans. Where are the spies? Old man, have you seen them?
They murdered these men in cold blood and they ran that like I'm pointing off in some other
They tried to steal a saw an airship from the docks. Let's get them. Adelaide, Warren, these guys don't know that you're specifically the spies. They go running past you for an airship and they're like, all right, cast off, let's find them in disguise.
And I like limp walk up to them. Now if everyone's finished playing around,
Miss Adeline and I will require new disguises, essentially. It's been a fun trip, to say the least.
Best go get changed then really quick and don't go into your office.
Yes, we have about checks. We have like a clock or something, like a
Watch. Sure. This is the most British thing I've ever seen, where you're like, there's a super weapon that's about to be deployed, an attack on Jamestown, and you're like, one moment, I need to go change my clothing and get a bit of tea.
We're all in, like, tuxes. Yeah, currently.
formal British wear. I'm into like the fake.
In comparison to when they're about to launch the meeting or whatever.
You've probably got less than half an hour.
Mm-hmm. We have about a half an hour for them to launch whatever weapon they have against the British. That's apparently what their meeting was about.
Oh, look, an elevator. Let's go right there.
There's no elevator. You're gonna have to climb the spire circle.
There's no steam elevator?
Nope.
Well, fuck, they didn't think this through.
Oh, they thought it through.
Vertically without the power of lift.
Because they can get in their airships and the people who need to be at the top can dock at the top.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, didn't think about that.
That's what I'm complaining about this the whole way up.
Can I fix my like overalls or something so that way they stay up?
Yes.
And then I'm just going to like on the way get like oil, just rub it all over my face to hide my features.
Yeah, so I'm complaining the whole way up, sure. And then I look at Doc and I'm just like, what the hell was that?
Oh, he was an MI6 agent back in the day. Don't worry about him.
Are you just saying that out loud in the middle of the spire?
Oh, no.
Okay, just make sure.
he's more than just a doc.
Look at him like partially glassy and say, high school fencing team. I turn and start walking off.
I give Adelaide the side eye, like, look at these motherfuckers.
Adelaide's holding her knife wound and glaring at Warren the whole way up.
What happened to you two?
Warren glares back, holding his sword wound. So you realize you brought more of them to me.
It is not my fault. You messed up that bad, and I got you out of it.
You've messed up just the same amount, just to tell you.
You got me stabbed.
You also got me stabbed.
It's a stab back, so you started it.
Very well, we will conclude this.
Nearby, argument. One of the shopkeepers is out, like, wiping something down. He goes, get a room, you two! Right here. 20 coppers. One room.
No, thank you.
Oh, all right. These kids today just flirting in public. This is a place of business. You make it to the 79th floor. This floor is sealed off. Rather than being like an open cave like all the other ones, there is a checkpoint, and there is a lift here that will take you from the 79th floor to the 80th. The 80th floor, of course, is the very top of the spire where the ceremony is taking place. Yeah. There is a large steam-driven piston door with two guards outside. They have aetheric rifles, and they are checking everybody that's going in for their identification gold bar to make sure that, you know, you're part of the special project.
I left it back on the ship.
You run back down the whole way?
No, I'm kidding.
So you present it to one of the guards, and they go, hey, man, I've never seen you around here before. When did you join the special project again?
Consultant. First time.
Who are you with?
Independent.
I searched back through my memory banks to see who the dude we interrogated was with.
He was with the Texans.
Yeah, he was with the Texans. Did he mention if the bars were like separate by clan or like by the group?
Anything like that. So he's just like, and who are you consulting with?
Texans.
Yeah, but who? Anybody can just walk up here and say they're with the Texans. You gotta know somebody.
I state the dude's name that we were talking with.
Oh yeah, you remember his name?
Tiberius.
I mean, Cornelius.
Oh, you're with Tiberius. Game. Okay. All right. Yeah, look, sorry. Tiberius, we got a security's extra tight today. Apparently, there's some British spies running around here.
Yes, you know, one of them tried to steal my
car. I'm sorry. Who the hell are you? Where's your bar?
My what?
Where's your bar?
Yeah, it was.
No, my outer.
Where's your bar?
Yeah, he's asking you where your bar is when you start
your
talking.
Gold bar to get entered. Yeah, we need. Yes. That's when we realized we all need gold bars.
Oh crap! You know, I think I might have left it back next on the nightstand. You know, I'm always doing that sort of thing. I remember back in the day, back in
no bar, no entry. What about you two?
You know, my sister would always go through and
we're with the consultant.
You know, it's just very
no bar, you know, no entry.
I'm gonna try and like lie my way through. It's like there must have been a mix up on the gold bar dispensary unit, and well, we didn't get. I was supposed to get the special gold bar, allowing me to have other people coming on with plus three. You know, as you do for consultancy. I work for a whole firm, you see, and I need these other experts. He is an expert in things and other stuff.
Okay. All right. These guys aren't idiots. The thing you're asking them for is going to be pretty tough. And I'm going to go ahead and just throw a story point behind it.
Can I counter with a similar story point?
Yes.
Yeah,
well, what's the difficulty first?
You can't directly counter me, but you can increase your
thing. Okay.
Because that direct countering thing got old real quick on Star Wars.
I can imagine.
The difficulty right now is 3 red and 2 black.
Fuck.
Yes. How do you assist?
I start talking about lengthy mechanical procedure just to make sure everything's in check.
My God, you're so boring. All right, take a blue die.
She wants to distract them by getting into very boring details.
Yeah. Yeah, you're going to test their patience.
And essentially, I'd like to help as well.
How do you do it?
I'm going to act as like the accountant and just start mumbling all sorts of formulas. And
you know what? I got to tell you guys, if a consulting firm came to my front door with only one identification card and was like, I'm the accountant. No, wait, I'm the mechanic. I'm a butler, you see. I would be like, this is an adventuring party right here. These people are trying to break in and steal the orb of Mythkalkos, okay?
Essentially, yes.
Okay, you have 2 blue dice added to your roll.
That's not enough, guys.
What's your roll?
It's 2 blue. I would have 2 blue, 1 yellow, 1 green.
That is not a great roll.
Against 2 black, 3 red.
Is there any way I can add an additional 8 onto that?
Yeah, or? How do you do it?
Well, I mean, because Cornelius is a smart
dude. You're butlering?
I'm buttling the shit out of things.
You take out a little brush and you begin brushing the master's imaginary lint off.
Uh-huh. Use this force point.
Uses his force.
Shit. Okay, so it's all right system, but wrong.
So yeah. 3 blue, and then what happens when I bump up story point or whatever destiny point?
Green will turn yellow.
But I don't have a green.
Then you get.
Do I have
green.
A green? Yeah, I do have a green. Wait, so how do I make a green turn yellow?
You just click upgrade 1 on your side.
Where's the upgrade button?
Oh, it's, you know,
beneath
what?
The blue dice.
Oh, I see.
All I did was click use player story point. It didn't actually factor into my role.
Well, you still
crushed. That's fine. Your role would have been even better then.
Yeah. What more do you want, Sid?
I want it all.
We flash and Sid's Emperor of the Universe. Okay, guys. See you next week.
How?
He kills a random chef.
I want it now.
All right. This is gonna go bad, guys.
I don't know if you guys noticed, but this overlay actually is the Dark Heresy overlay, but with a map in the background.
Am I using, I'm using Deception, right?
Yes, you are.
I need to investigate this.
We'll see how well it is.
It actually is.
Can it be negotiation? or coercion?
I will allow it to be negotiation. Go ahead.
I don't know if that's any better, to be honest, but okay.
I don't know if it's any better.
Actually, yeah, it is.
You sold me on it, though.
All right, let's do it.
No, oh. No.
Right.
No. Wait, no, that's a triumph. No. That's God, that is a triumph.
Advantage.
But you still fail the roll, unfortunately.
Oh, because there's no successes.
There's no successes.
That's so weird.
I mean, let me look up what that triumph's going to buy you. Talk amongst yourselves. Maybe talk about the wonders of Twitch Prime real quick while I look it up.
Is that still a thing? I thought they were, you know, losing it eventually.
Wait, I thought the triumph also
triumph. It is already calculated into the successes. So if it doesn't show any successes, then you have failed. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Twitch Prime is still a thing, though. What I hear is you still get advertisements, which are mind-blowingly insane these days, the Twitch advertisements. Oh, my God. They're blowing my mind. You can't even skip them now because they embed them into the video. Oh, it's so frustrating. As someone who bounces around on Twitch all the time, it's like I just have like six Twitch tabs open now all the time because I don't want to hear three or four ads for Metro, the new Metro game or whatever it's called.
Here's the deal, Hero. These guys aren't going to buy it. You can see that they are on the verge of extreme violence. But with that triumph, you can do something vital, such as getting all of the guards' attentions to allow the rest of your team to do something.
Okay.
What do you do to get the guards' attention so that the rest of your team are doing something while they're all looking away?
What would I do to get their attention?
You want to do some gun tricks real quick? Flip your gun around and be like, hey guys, look at this!
No, that's so stupid. That's so stupid. Who would do that?
You watched Wild Wild West and you're going to call that the stupid thing.
Can I? I'm assuming they have gold bars on them.
These two guys?
Guards. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So can I like grab one of their gold bars, slip it and like chuck it over the side of the off the spire?
That pisses that guy off immediately. Like, the second dude is like going for you. He's like, that's it. You're coming with us.
I just like grab it, chuck it, like shoot him, shoot him.
Are there only two guards?
There are only two guards.
Shoot him.
Is there anybody else in the area?
I mean, if you start shooting, the people that are one level above you are definitely going to hear.
We're not going to shoot them.
Stand right in front of me.
So there's like a window.
I think what's going
to
happen.
Yeah, there's several holes built into the side of the spire to allow wind to come in and out so that they can
throw them over the edge.
Cornelius is going to stab one and...
All right.
We'll brawl the other one, yeah.
So if you want to... If you want to throw somebody out the window, you're going to require a triumph on a brawl roll. You're going to need a critical success.
No, I was just asking.
Okay. Well, you can certainly attempt to
knock somebody out with brawl. Like, come up behind.
You can just bam, bam. Yep.
I'm going to assist her.
Okay. Cornelius, two purple. Adelaide, two purple. Also, add a black die to that. So two purple, one black for all these rolls.
Do I get to ignore that with my brawl thing?
Yes, you do.
Yeah. Do they get any blues for my awesome distraction skills?
No, that the awesome distraction skills are allowing them to even make this roll in the first place.
Yeah.
Otherwise, the roll would be don't explode when you are filled with etheric energy.
Do I get the blue from
yes, you helping? Do.
Okay.
And so if you want to use a force die again. Story die.
Yeah, I'll use a story die.
Yeah, I could use one. You go ahead and throw it back at me. Thanks.
So
a zero, Adelaide. You go forward to box with this guy. He just holds his etheric rifle up, and you just hit the rifle, and you're like, ow.
So what does that do for me?
It will upgrade one of your dice from green to yellow, or lower one of their dice from red to purple.
Okay, so how do I... Oh, upgrade... upgrade one. Did I just hit upgrade one?
Yep.
Okay. All right, here we go.
This is your moment in the sun. All right. You don't kill this guy, but you do hit him with the sword, and it does hurt. One of the guys begins going, alert! Alert! We're being invaded! Who knows who these people are? The both of them begin shouldering their etheric rifles.
Even with me, like, he's trying to shoulder his rifle, and I'm like, right there?
Yes. You're slashing at him. You force him.
No, just coming in with a stab.
Yeah, okay. You're stabbing at him. Like right he's there. Falling back as much as he can, and you're just not
following right with him.
You're just not as fast as he is. He's young. He's on guard. He's ready for it, and he's got the rifle up.
I don't buy it.
Well, unfortunately, your sword only deals 1 point of damage, which is not nearly enough to kill this guy.
So what you're saying is I shouldn't be bringing the sword to a gunfight.
Sid, I didn't want to say it out loud, but Basically, any weapon deals more damage than your sword.
Nice. I liked it.
Can't use the gun, though. Make too much noise.
Yeah. That's a problem for you, not a problem for them.
Can we just shoot them? I mean, that's the answer. They already yelled, like, right? Like, I shoot. I pull my pistol and I'm
fucking... I was going to try to say something. Because at this point, we've already been made.
Yeah, they already yelled. There's no point.
Yeah, and I was going to try to... The Mexicans are trying to bring back the Alamo.
Ooh, that's a sore sticking point, okay? That's fighting dirty, sir. Bringing up the memory of the Alamo, that's like saying remember the Maine, all right?
Yeah.
No one nowadays remembers the Maine. I don't know if anyone here could actually name what the Maine was.
I don't even know what that is.
You know, see, exactly.
Google this and point be proven.
Okay, Warren. Let's start with you. I would like you to make a leadership roll.
Okay.
Your leadership roll is to draw all loyal Texans to the area to fight the inevitable Mexican takeover of the secret weapon.
Uh-huh.
All right. You're rolling against 3 red.
Mm-hmm.
They have strong bonds of loyalty. Everybody knows they're here for a peaceful ceremony. It's going to be tough to start some ruckus here. What you want to do, G?
Spin a story die to bump one of those red down to 3.
Okay. You're now 2 red, 1 purple.
And I think that's about all I can do.
Okay. All right. I hope you're good at leadership. You are not. You fucking suck really incredibly bad at it. That's 2 failures and a despair. Oh my god.
No, I'm starting to feel a little bit like what it's like for you guys to play with me.
Yeah, but see, here's the thing. In most systems, when you roll bad, it doesn't call more enemies in. Warren failed his check, and now, like, a boss is showing up. Sub-boss. I'll figure this out in a second.
So Jamestown is dead.
Wallace.
I'll see you guys in 5 years.
What's your plan, Wallace? You're gonna shoot?
Yeah.
All right.
We're going in guns blazing. I shout, fuck this. I shout for the queen.
There are 2 targets. There are 2 targets. One is completely uninjured, and the other is engaged in melee combat against Cornelius and is trying to bring his rifle around.
I'm gonna let Cornelius do his shit. That man needs no help. Okay.
I want to point out that his sword is weaker than... His sword is just as good as punching people, basically.
But he has the power of belief on his side.
All right, very well.
And that's good enough for me.
Okay.
So I'm going to shoot against a thing. What am I shooting against?
2 purple.
2 purple. This is doable.
Uh-huh. Oh, sorry, there's a black die. You didn't succeed anyway. You have an advantage die. What do you want to do with it? You could recover a strain. You could add a blue to an ex character's check. You could point out an important detail in an ongoing situation. That might be.
Yeah, I'm gonna. Can I point out like a ventilation grate?
You do point out a ventilation grate, and from that ventilation grate, it gets kicked out, and somebody jumps down out of it.
Who the fuck? That's what I look at them. And I'm like, who the fuck?
They land.
I know, Mike. Who the fuck are you?
They are wearing Admiral Arthur's aetheric armor. They're wearing like a clockwork power suit around them. They're a mongrel like you, but they have Doc Octopus 4 spider arms behind them.
Doesn't that make him a good guy?
No, he is definitely here to kill you. When he shows up, there's a little Borderlands style bad guy intro.
Like, what's the name? Yeah, what's the tag?
I'm Mongrel.
His name is Doc Mongrel. Look, I'm not working with a lot of time here. I have to make up a whole new bad guy to kick your ass based on this horrible role. And he's just like, so you've come to my project then. Now I will destroy you, British spies. You think you can trick people into breaking us apart? And as he says this, like all four of his steam arms menace and steam comes out of them.
Aren't you a spy yourself?
No, I am here to take back the British Empire in the name of freedom.
I'm pretty sure you are a British spy if you're a mongrel.
He leaps for you.
Shit.
You're so bad at this. Pondo, what the fuck?
All right. Let's start. I need to get actions from each of you in the upcoming combat.
Terrible.
You are facing down Doc Mongrel, who is a steam-assisted cyber warrior.
Jesus Christ.
You're also facing down two heavy guardsmen, one of whom is armed and slightly injured.
I mean, I don't have a gun at the moment because mine got melted.
That is a very serious problem for you. Hero, what's your plan?
Oh, God damn it. It's going on. He's going on Warren?
Yes.
I'm going to shoot the guy that I shot at before.
Okay.
No, fuck it. Hero thinks about the meaning of his name for a second. And I look at Adelaide. It's like slow motion. I to Adelaide to like see how she's doing. How does Adelaide look? What's like the expression that you're giving? Are you like worried? Are you like intent? Are you like gonna run?
She looks a little bit worried, considering the guy she tried to knock out was completely unaffected.
Oh God damn it! Hero's just gonna shout. He's gonna go, Adelaide, to me, and I'm gonna shoot the same guy that I shot at before. I'm gonna start backing up towards, making my way towards the vent.
The one that Adelaide's boxing with. So yeah.
Okay. Sure.
Okay.
Shot against two purple.
Well, I just need to get everybody's action before we move ahead.
Oh, okay.
Cornelius, what's going on with you?
My apologies. I'm getting DM'd a lot from Mr. Trip G Manlives from
I don't know who that is, but
he's a YouTuber I covered in my video today.
Oh, okay. All right. Look, I'll give you a moment. Cotton.
No, it's fine. What? It's fine. This is what I'm here for, so this is my priority. So right now, I've been trying to stab this guy. He's backing up. Was he trying to shoot at me, or is he trying
to shoot? He is about to shoot you.
He's about to shoot you. I took the gun from the dude we captured. Can I just
shoot him?
Shoot him.
Yeah. Okay. Shoot the guard.
I don't know what stats this gun has.
Don't worry. I'll let you know when you make your shot.
Okay.
Warren, what's your plan? I can't hear you.
Can I spin a story die to kamikaze myself explosion style into the Doc Mongrel? Try and take him.
What is exploding in this situation?
Like TNT?
You want to have TNT on you, and you want to jump at a dude with six arms, hold yourself to them, and blow yourself up?
Yeah. Why don't you just push him out the window?
Yeah. Well, look, with the way Pondo's been rolling, he's going to push himself out the window.
Yes.
He's going to blow himself up is what he suggests.
I want to be very clear here. The amount of TNT required to kamikaze you and him is also going to injure or kill everyone in this room. They will probably never hear again, even if they survive. But I'll allow
I have an idea.
Very well.
Can I try to book it and kamikaze myself?
What is with the kamikazing, Pondo? Is there a plan you have that doesn't involve ruthlessly sacrificing yourself? Have you thought maybe just like throwing some TNT?
I could try.
Yeah.
Essentially, I'd like to book it to
up or down.
To wherever the possibility of the super weapon is.
You're standing in front of the steam piston door that will let you into the spire and where that is.
Okay.
Because you guys were at the checkpoint at the door.
I can't
open it. So let me describe the area so that you have a better view.
Yes.
You are on the outer layer of a rock spire. You're on the 79th floor. Off to a side, there is a steam-powered lift that will take you from 79 to 80. There are several holes in the wall in order to allow for some level of aeration. And there is a path downwardly that runs throughout the whole spire along the outer edge. And if you were particularly tall enough or could jump real well, you could get to that ventilation shaft that leads into the laboratory where the secret weapon is that the Doc Mongrel came out of. You are all standing directly in front of the laboratory door.
Can it I open it? Or
is it is steam piston powered, and someone on the other side will have to open it.
Gotcha.
You could open it with some TNT. Dynamite. Yeah, TNT. You can win the fight. TNT, it's a power load. What do you want to do?
Wait, would that be bad? Because
yeah, it'll be bad setting off an explosion right next to everybody.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm just going to try to see if I can go in, jump into the shaft, the ventilation All right. shaft.
So this guy jumps down. Your plan is to jump up and pull yourself in.
Yeah, I'm just going to use him like a step stool as much as possible.
Okay, you're going to Mario jump. All right, yes. Got it. Mario jump. Adelaide. Things are not looking great in this area.
So we can use a story dice to like have something?
Yes.
Can I use a story dice to pull out a flashbang?
Yes.
Okay.
She's gonna
pull out this flashbang and like signal the rest of the group because we've worked together before by putting her goggles on.
Okay.
So like give them a hint that it's coming. And then just throw it to as many of them as I can.
Okay. Let's start with the flashbang. I need you to make a ranged light roll versus two purple. Every success will indicate an extra person who's affected.
I gotta use the story point to have it though, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh my goodness, look at all of those story points on my side. It's going to be a bad round for you guys.
It's going to be a bad round because I don't have this like weapon, like throwing thing.
That is very unfortunate for someone who is about to toss a grenade to not be good at grenade tossing.
Well, I wasn't sure what it used, to be honest. Ranged light?
Yep.
And two purple?
Yep.
Okay. Well...
That's bad.
Yeah.
Adelaide, you toss your wonderful flashbang, handcrafted by you. Have you ever played Counter-Strike before? So here's what happens. You throw out the canister, it soars gloriously through the air. It hits the wall and bounces back and stops directly in front of your face. You got your goggles down and it explodes right in front of you and you're like, ah! No one else in the area is affected but you. You take 1 point of strain damage.
Lovely.
Next up, Warren, you're making your Mario jump. Just because you're using this guy as a boost, I'm going to give you one blue die.
Okay. What's my difficulty?
Ooh, you are trying to jump for something above your height. Three purple dice. Athletics.
It's not as bad as I thought it was going
to
be.
Now the real question is, Cotton, can you get your cat to wear the goggles? Don't think so, huh? No?
No, a lot of things.
Shit. Warren, you go to jump on this guy's head and go farther up. He doesn't give a shit. One of his steam arms reaches up and grabs you by the leg and slams you back down on the ground. go ahead and take one point of strain.
Okay.
Next up, Doc Mongrel is going to beat the shit out of Warren.
Okay.
So, Warren, what is your, what do you call it then there, your defense? Do you have any armor on?
Probably not, because, okay, you know, I just went into overalls.
Okay. Well, this is going to end poorly, and I'm going to go ahead and spend a story point to boost him to the next level.
Okay. So how dead am I?
Well, we'll find out in a second. You take 5 points of damage, and he gains a point of strain. So your soak will absorb some of that.
Okay.
And then you take however many wounds are left.
Okay.
How you doing?
I'm not doing great.
So you have to clam up as you slam on the ground. You roll around. This guy's hitting you with 3 mechanical arms, 2 of his regular arms. The 4th mechanical arm's got a cigar for him to smoke as he's just beating the fuck out of you on the ground. Next up, Cornelius. You got one last shot before this guy shoots you. And you know if he shoots you, it's going to end bad. You've stabbed him a little bit. If you want to stab him real good, you need more successes. You need a lot of successes, because each success gives you another point of damage.
No, I think I'm going to shoot him.
Right. Oh, that's right. You had set up to shoot. Go ahead. Mm-hmm. You drop the sword cane. You whip out your gun. Pull out your pistol.
It was the pistol I picked up because I had a weapon, but I don't know what happened to it. So
go ahead. Make a ranged light roll.
Ranged light roll against what?
Two purple.
Just two purple.
One black. He's got armor.
Two purple, one black, and let's see. We need to go to skills. Ranged light. Ooh. Can this be ranged?
Ranged light.
Damn it.
You know, okay, you had a chance to stick with the sword, but you chose not to.
I did. Oh my god.
And
that's where it all falls apart.
You can toss a blue die to somebody if you want. Or you can add a black die to that particular person's next roll.
I'll do that.
Okay. So when he shoots you, it'll be harder.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's go with him shooting you then. He's got 2 yellow. He's shooting against 2 purple and a black. Would anyone like the story point to make this harder?
Sit, would you like it?
You're closer to death than me, so.
I mean, it's a matter of there's not much else going on in the situation. It's either I try to get up in that vent next turn, I don't make it, I'm just dead anyway.
Nah, just let him shoot me. Okay. I'm sure it'll be amazing. He fails.
Look. Your shots go wide. He pulls the trigger on the etheric rifle. Then he looks down because it's not firing. And at that moment, the delayed charge goes off and it just hits a wall and the wall starts melting. And he's just like, ah! Vaya con Dios, amigo!
Yes, raw indeed, you uncouth heathen.
Which wall did it hit?
It hit the wall that the lift was next.
How big of a hole did it melt?
It didn't melt a hole so much as melt a hole. You know, it definitely shaved off like 2 inches of the rock. Not enough to hop through a, you know, multi-foot level barrier into the area. Hero, you are shooting the uninjured guard. Let's go ahead and do that before he shoots back at you.
Yeah. What am I against? What am I rolling
2
against?
2 purple, 1 black.
2 purple, 1 black.
Show me the power of your rolls.
God damn it. That's bad, right? Well, it's not horrible.
I mean, just nothing happens.
Nothing. You have an advantage. You could recover a strain, pass a blue die along to the next person to act on your side, which would be whoever starts next turn.
Can I ask a weird question?
Yep.
Dr. Mongrel, why did he come to us through a ventilation shaft?
That's where Mongrels come from, right?
That's racist.
I'll agree with that.
Why? Like, if he's the doctor running this operation, couldn't he have just used the door?
That's true. He could have used the door.
Maybe he was just hanging up there waiting for somebody to pass so he could jump up, you know, have his moment in the sun.
Have you ever played an MMO and wondered where the bosses come out from when they do their intro theme, you know? Like,
I know, but like, part of me, because of this, makes me want to be like, stop, hold on, guys. Why did you come through the ventilation channel? Like, ask him that, but you, I know.
Because he's like, I like it up there. It's nice and cool. I was taking a break while the weapon was charging. Okay? So sue me. You're going to make fun of me because I'm a mongrel? You're going to make fun of me because I'm a mongrel? He starts punching York even harder.
Oh, God. Why? I know it was just because Arthur needed a way to introduce the villain, and I was mentioning the chef. So he's like, here you go. But now I'm like,
exactly.
What? What was he doing?
Catching a fresh breath of air.
Is there a panel on the door for me to like slip the gold bar into to have it open, or
no?
Like...
So you get the idea that the guards would like knock on the door and say it's okay for somebody to enter.
Oh, okay.
There's not like an identification thing.
And then Adelaide, how was she? I miss her turn. I miss your turn.
She's fine. She's fine.
Okay. Fine.
It's Warren who's getting beat to death.
I'm gonna slip into the shaft. I'm out.
So you're just gonna run away? You're like,
Not running away.
Okay, all right. You're heading down.
Forward.
Okay, down. Back down.
I want to go into the room with the thing.
The room with the thing.
I'm going into the secret. I'm going through these fucking doors through the shaft.
There's no opening the door though. The door is closed.
Are you saying you want to go through the vent? Because that's
I want to go. Yeah, through the vent to get into the room.
You're
with the
switching
weapon.
What you're doing. You're gonna try to jump up to the vent.
Yeah.
All right. Well,
yeah, I take my shitty ass shot, I miss, and I'm gonna book it towards the vent.
It's a 3 purple athletics check.
Okay, to like jump up to the vent?
Yes. Yep.
Okay. Am I good at athletics? Oh, fuck.
I don't know. Are you good at athletics?
Shit, I'm not. There's no way. All right, well, I stop. Look at how high that vent is.
You're committed, brother. You're committed now. Let's
do
this.
Well, now I see how high it is. When I run to the vent, I see how high it is, and I don't try it.
Okay, all right.
Because I know it's pointless. I'm going to yell at Adelaide. I'm going to turn around again and yell at Adelaide to get over here. Give me a hand.
The dude that you were shooting at, you run past him in order to get to the vent. He notices you stop to look at the vent, and he's like, gotcha, and takes a shot while you're stopped.
Yep, that's reasonable.
That's a triumph,
bad, isn't it?
Yes,
that's
it
bad
is
for me.
You take a critical hit in the process. All right, so you're going to take 5 points of damage minus your soak.
Okay,
how's wounds. Your wounds? So, you good?
So my wounds goes up 5
minus your soak.
Oh, 4.
Okay. Yep,
I'm at 4. I'm
all fine. Right. Let me find the critical hit table because you just got critically hit.
Oh, yeah.
I need you to roll a D100 to see how critical you are.
Ooh, I like this already.
Yeah, this could be bad.
That feels good. Ooh!
69. That's my password, by the way. You remove all blue dye from skill checks until your critical injury is healed. Your senses have been scattered. So write down you have a 2 purple scattered senses.
Okay.
That means you cannot be assisted by anyone until you see a doctor. Hopefully that doctor is good.
Good thing I'm a doctor.
This guy shoots at you with the aetheric rifle, and it goes right past your head. There's a little... Oh, you can smell it. Your ear smells like bacon right now. Having that much aetheric energy near a brain is not good. You're like, Two squared plus 3 squared is equal to 4 squared.
Just
Adelaide,
breakfast right now. Am I having a stroke?
The thing, Adelaide, thing, vent.
All right. I feel like we did discuss if this needed to be, it would actually be a 2-parter. Is everyone good with coming back next week to see how this fucking ends? Because we're stuck.
Yeah,
Look, Cotton, sure. I know I mocked you about the door yesterday because I always find door jokes very funny, but you guys are stuck outside a door for over 2 hours.
I'm pretty sure how this ends is just us all dying.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure we're gonna
die. I think we can do it.
That's what happens when you're in the special air service. Sometimes you live, you die, and someone tells your story.
It's the beauty of one.
Unless
shot.
I can make this athletic roll to get in there, not much else is happening.
You could fight and win, you know. Like
I have nothing to fight with.
Come on, that's how Starship Troopers, that song goes. We're gonna fight and we're gonna win.
I'm pretty sure none of us are built for combat at all, actually.
I mean, from what I saw.
The next session will be an hour of pre-show banter, 30 minutes of us dying, and an hour of post-show banter. It sounds great.
I have combat skills, but it's just brawling.
Well, the good news is that you can just punch somebody to death in this game.
I was going to ask you the damage on brawling for the next thing. To see
it
what
is your brawn.
Your brawn is two.
Okay, well then you deal 2 damage plus the number of successes you have.
My punches is
brawl combat skill.
Hmm?
There's actually a brawl combat skill.
I have it.
Yes.
Damn.
I'm good at it.
Yeah. Okay, guys. We are in a bit of a sticky wicket. Just a small... No, I gotta be super British about it. Very understatement. You've encountered a slight problem. But it will be easily overcome with the generous wit that you have applied so far.
Was that your super British?
I tried. We'll see if the British people in chat agree with me or not.
Ooh,
look, I'm gonna tell you a British story, okay? There was this time where a British position, I'm pretty sure it was in World War II, was being completely overrun by, I think it was Italians. And they were like, American colleagues, we have a slight problem here. The American general, not realizing that in British, that meant we were totally fucked and someone should come help us, ignored the message because he thought, slight problem, no big deal. All of the British people died.
Is that a real story or is that just like a British joke?
No, that actually happened. World War II.
Oh.
America and England speak the same language but don't always understand each other. Now that I've brought the room down, bring the room back up with our local positivity life coach, Cotton. Thanks for joining us. I'm glad that Pondo could ruin everything around you. So basically, it was a normal game for you.
Just like it's just real life. It's just...
Let's do some outros. Who are you? Where can people find you? What do you do? How do you feel about cosplaying as a steampunk next week?
I'll do it as Sid does it.
Sid, you doing it?
Yeah, I'll do it.
Pondo, you doing it?
Or Pondo, anybody.
I probably won't be doing it.
Pondo, I heard that you were doing it.
Let me go to Amazon right now.
Swargula, how do you feel about doing a little bit of cosplay? Maybe get some goggles? Maybe get a little...
Swarg is paycheck to paycheck these days, so that's a no. Unless someone can buy it for me, I'll do it if that happens, but otherwise, no.
You could get some makeup and do a little gear face paint, you know?
I do not have makeup, and makeup is expensive. You're a girl, you should know this.
I don't really wear makeup.
Oh, okay. I'm wearing makeup right now, motherfucker.
Actually, you probably makeup are.
Makeup
is super expensive. What do you do, light powder?
I do have a little bit of makeup that I have gotten for various things. It's last several years. I'm not sure if I'm supposed to keep it for several years, but I've had it for several years. And it was, like, at the Dollar Tree. Mm. Or,
I
you know,
oh, yeah.
Walgreens
has
makeup.
All right.
I don't know what size hat to get.
It's fine. We'll just pressure Pondo into cosplaying as well. That's what peer pressure's for.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe you could get, like, mouse ears since you're, like, a were-rat.
Look, if you Amazon it to me, go to town.
I mean, you could cut little circles out of paper and then just put them on your head hat.
I would have to buy scissors.
Okay. Got me there. I got
no,
there.
I'm kidding. I own scissors. I'm not.
Cotton, when you're not suggesting things for Swargula to do, what else are you doing?
I was just trying to help.
No, it's fine. I think it's going to be hilarious.
I doodle a bunch.
That's true.
I got animals to take care of.
I understand you run multiple play-by posts now, including a secret one.
I do.
Wait, there's a secret one?
There's a secret one.
Why is one secret?
I don't know. Why is one secret?
Secrets.
It's not really a secret when we keep talking about it.
Yeah, are there...
Yeah, because nobody else knows anything about it or can see it.
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay, so the others are open.
One climb
it's
mouth.
A hidden one.
It's a hente one. There.
What? No.
No.
There's a... What was I going to say? You know, it's... for the private cool people... I guess it's a click.
I'm glad to be in that click of private
It's like the Playboy poster. You have to get past the red velvet rope.
Mm. Oh, Arthur's a player in that Playboy poster?
He is.
Ooh, okay. Arthur, how would you describe Cottontail's GMing style?
Doors are not in our favor.
She's also
GMing style.
Okay.
Doors is just not great.
All right.
I remember when Pondo spent 36 hours to open a door by kicking it.
You put that hex on me, Ricky Bobby?
Response.
Put that hex on me.
I was trying to figure out what would happen if you kicked a sliding door made of stone for a while. I was just like, and then he just kicked it again. So I'm just like, stop.
Because I was waiting for a response.
I was also at work, for the record. Impatient.
Are these Playboy posts on your Discord?
I do have a Playboy post that you can join on my Discord. It's and very slow.
And I believe you have a Patreon as well. You don't have a Patreon. I tried. I'm trying to help you out here on these shout outs. I don't know.
I wouldn't even know what to put on my Patreon. Like
drawings. I don't know.
Drawings that I deleted that you can see now before I delete them. I don't know.
Felt cute, might delete later.
Yeah. I have a Twitter that I don't use a whole lot unless I'm having a sale. I'll post it on my Twitter. That's about it.
Pondo, who are you? Where can people find you? What do you do?
I am Pondo, or you can call me Pondothemad. I play video games and whatnot and record them very much on occasion and then upload them to YouTube. I do occasionally stream as well, like I did this earlier today. And you can find me at Twitch or YouTube /Pondothemad, respectively. Or you can just come to AP's Discord and I'll talk to you there. I usually hang around there. Come in, say a good quip real quick. Just AP's real desire to kill his players because he wants to win so badly.
Name one time in the last 3 years I've killed the players. There was a time where I left player corpses left and right. I'm not even talking about characters. I left players dead left and right. Where do you think Craig went?
What about New Game Plus?
New Game Plus was designed to be hard specifically because when they die, they come back to life at the beginning of the campaign.
It counts.
It does not count. Don't even give me that shit, motherfucker.
It's not character death.
Because players...
It's not character death if they never die.
Yeah.
They do die, though.
Are we to be two immortals locked in a battle forever?
It's like saying the main characters in Altered Carbon die, you know? Well, yeah, they do. Oh
my
but...
God, Altered Carbon.
No, season 2, man. No. It's so fucking good.
Please, no. Okay. Anything else you got going on, Pondo?
No, that's about it.
Sid?
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, I am SIdAlpha. I did have fun tonight. My apologies, I was a bit sidetracked there from time to time, but I still mostly managed to keep engaged with what was going on. I hope I managed to make things at least mildly entertaining for everyone with my rendition of an old man who had his moment in the sun with a sword, slashing down four people simultaneously. And that's kind of like, you get one good roll, and then...
You know what that's like.
Back to rolling garbage again, and... That's probably going to be my rules for the rest of the night or rest of the game is going to be just hot garbage, but that's okay. I'm going to be back here with Arthur and Cotton on Monday. We're going to be playing Made RPG, where I'm going to be playing a butler, so I get to practice more buttling, because that's what butlers do, they buttle. And we're also going to be back on Thursday for more Battletech, where Lexi Tales tries to horribly murder Cotton, Pondo, myself, and Ranosaurus, and Arthur gets to mock us and play Fate Grand Order or some other mobile game that he likes to play.
I let the chat do all the GMing for me this time, actually. It worked out pretty well.
Nice. And
because I refused to help this time.
Yeah, you were a huge dick about it, too.
Exactly.
In the meantime, when I'm not here messing with Arthur's games, I'll be on my YouTube channel, youtube.com/SIdAlpha, where I do a lot of industry commentary, gaming news. I've actually got a couple of reviews in the works that I haven't done in a very long time, so that'll be fun. At least for me, it'll be fun. So we'll see what goes on there. So yeah, tune into my YouTube channel, see what happens with all that. That's all I got.
Sam.
Yeah, tell me about it.
No, you tell me about it.
That's
who are you? Where can people find you? And what do you do? Tell me about it.
I thought you were pretending to be my therapist for a second. That's how they start every conversation I have with them. That's not true. They're not a real person. And let's see. I'm the guy that does a little bit of fucking everything, man. I got a lot of things in the works. A lot of projects that are like there at some varying degree of thing. Usually you can keep up with that on my diary/Twitter at Swargula, which usually I tweet about things like my ex, you know, or politics, or, you know, whatever. Generally it's jokes about my ex, though. Let's be real. Other times I do stream every blue moon. Usually it's music, but me playing music, that's really it. But yeah, that's whatever. So that's it. I just had a good time. It was fun. It was fun being back. I like my boy Arthur. I like all of Arthur's community a whole lot. He does a really good job here. I can't say enough good things. So if you haven't already Amazon Prime subbed to Arthur, definitely do that. Also, yeah, the other guys are okay too. No, I'm kidding. It was super fun. I love the crew. And I'm actually like the characters. I'm so excited because these characters, like, right when we were like halfway through, I was like, these characters are deep. Like, for one shot, these characters are like, I'm like, I want like this much more. I have like that itch, you know, where I'm like, I want more, you know. I want to know more about all of your characters a little bit. Like, I want Sid and MI6 to come up again, right? Like, I want to know about Hero and Adelaide in the back and like the background, right? I want to know about Warren's past, like that kind of shit. So Mike, I'm interested, which is rare for me.
I mean, next round you're going to get like a whole bunch of more pieces with you, just not the type that you expect.
Yeah, just my limbs will be in separate places. Yeah. Yeah, it was a good time. Thanks for having me.
We will be back next Saturday at 8 Eastern for another run of this, instead of me sitting down and doing Pokemon prep. So I'll have to delay getting your character by one day, Cotton. But don't worry, we'll have it after that. Next week, I mean, I have streams every day. So, yeah, until next Friday, I'm super busy. Watch everything I do. Don't watch anybody else ever. I'm trying to think of some more super yandere stalkerish stuff to say. That's pretty much it, right? Like, don't ever go see anyone else and only watch me. There we go. Any wise wisdom before we break here? Do you guys have a plan next week? There's a lot of jumping for the ventilation shaft that appears to be.
That's about it, because yeah, I don't have any brawling to, you know.
Yeah, I mean, if we die, I'm totally. I'm ready. Like, my expectations are we'll our show next week will be 30 minutes of us dying, and then we'll do like an hour and a half of flashbacks. And like
I think we can do it.
There it is. There's that Cotton optimism. All right, we'll see how that goes down.
You know, I have no gun.
You know, the best way to get a gun would be to use a story point.
Bear? That is a thing.
Have a good night, guys.